The Pulse Network. It's what's next now.
Hi, everybody. I'm Butch Stearns of the Pulse Network at thepulsenetwork.com. We're talking Future M here in downtown Boston at the headquarters of CSN Stores. Joining me right now is Jeff Busking from Flybridge Capital Partners. Hello, Jeff. How are you?
Hi, Butch. Good to see you.
Tell us about Flybridge Capital Partners.
We're an early stage venture capital firm. We focus on technology companies, handful of people, good ideas, typically pre-revenue, and we are five partners here in Boston.
Awesome. Let's talk about marketing in general. Let's talk about Future M. Let's talk about New England and maybe the future of marketing. The event Future M, were you involved in it last year? What do you think about it? And it's coming up in September again this year?
Yeah, no, I'm really excited about it. I'm on the board of MIDEX, so I was very involved last year and I hosted an event that we had with DataZoo, one of my portfolio companies, which is one of the hot new companies here in Boston in the marketing technology field, talking about the future of advertising. You know, and Boston's got a spectacular ecosystem of technology companies that are transforming advertising and media, and very synergistic with what's going on in New York, and we're just taking advantage of that.
As far as the digital world, as far as the future of marketing, I mean, let me use my company, our company, as an example. We started this from scratch. The Pulse Network, programming-wise, is kind of a combination of TV and talk radio with an entirely different use of social media than mainstream media uses. But what we've grown into is so much more. We have seven companies under our roof, so we have a social media agency. We have an events company, so it's all about content. And people say that in digital media and all that, but when you talk about marketing, down to its basic form, it's messaging, it's how you're doing it. But one of the things I've learned coming from the mainstream media world and making the leap into this world is the push versus the pull mentality. Is that in this day and age, if you're a business, you really want to, you hear these words all the time, but you really want to engage people. You don't want to hammer people with messages. So when you talk about the future of marketing, the future of messaging that you're sending out to people, it really is a soft sell, isn't it? It's a different sell than it has been for years and years.
Yeah, I think it's even more textured than that as an investor. As an investor, I look at things like new ways of interacting with consumers, what you're describing. Push and pull can both be extremely effective, but as long as you're doing it digitally, leveraging social, local, mobile channels. I look at platforms, whether they're technology platforms that help transform the marketing equation, loyalty platforms, CRM platforms. You know, we've got a great tradition in Boston of terrific software companies and SaaS models that are allowing advertisers to transform the way they're dealing with consumers in a very powerful way. And the final thing is consumer value. You know, how is the consumer actually getting value from the advertiser? And companies that are helping facilitate that, I think, can be terrific and very powerful companies.
You know, the interesting thing, I'm in a position to manage the company, and we hire a lot of young people. And I teach as much as I learn. I'm going to use my daughters as an example. My wife and I have three daughters, 14, 10, and 12. And my 10-year-old said to me recently, as she was DVRing and trying to get to a program she watched, "Daddy, you grew up in a generation where you had to watch a TV program at a certain night at a certain time." It was like having the 8-track conversation with her. She didn't get it. So to your point about being mobile, about using all different platforms, doing whatever, it's a generation now, whether you're a millennial or whether you're a retiree, it's a generation where you can get things where you want, when you want, and how you want. So you have to innovate or die, basically. You have to explore all platforms, all ways to do things, or your message is never going to get to the people that you want to get to.
Yeah, I mean, the transformative platform technologies that are available to us today and our kids today, as you're saying, Butch, are extraordinary. I mean, it's what makes me so bullish about the future of technology. I mean, you look at tablet computing, which is a phenomenon over the last 12 to 18 months. You look at the smartphone proliferation, which is a phenomenon of the last 24 to 36 months. Broadband access, the way small businesses are engaging in the digital ecosystem, unlocking billions of dollars of potential opportunity. It really is an extraordinary and exciting time.
So final question, what about the future of marketing? What about Boston in particular? What makes Boston unique?
Well, you know, we've had a fantastic tradition of two forces in Boston. One is technology. We have a spectacular software and technology infrastructure, great developers, great creative minds and architects. And then secondly, we have a direct marketing history dating back from Michael Bronner starting Digitas out of his dorm room at Boston University in 1980. We've been a direct marketing hub. And when you notice that all of marketing is going to digital, and a lot of marketing more and more is going to direct, You know, we've got some great assets and a long history here and a long tradition that make us in a very powerful position.
Jeff, thanks for spending a few minutes.
Yeah, my pleasure.
Nice getting to know you a little bit. All right, he's Jeff Buskang. I'm Butch Stearns. We're talking the future of marketing, Future M. We're here at the headquarters of CSN Stores in downtown Boston. It's the Pulse Network at thepulsenetwork.com.